Recorded Books Incorporated presents an unabridged recording of Song Lee in Room 2B by Suzy Kline. Narrated by Johnny Heller.
Shy Song Lee. Miss Mackle looked out the window of Room 2B. It's snowing in March? Harry jumped out of his seat. Hot dog! Come and see, Doug. All right, I said, slapping Harry Five. It was fun watching the snow stick to the playground and treetops. When I turned around, everybody was up at the windows, except Song Lee. The teacher smiled at her. You have permission to leave your seat. Thank you, Miss Mackle. Miss Mackle sighed. I wish everyone in our second grade class had your good manners, Song Lee. Stop pushing! Dexter shouted. Harry held up a fist. You're in my face. Move over, scuzzball. Dexter put up two fists. Make me, lizard breath. Harry and Dexter are fighting, Sydney called. Miss Mackle waved her hands in the air. That's it. Everyone sit down. Harry and I shot Sydney a look. His tattling always got us in trouble. After we returned to our seats, Miss Mackle looked at the class. No one was smiling. Most of us were moaning. I think we all have a case of cabin fever, Miss Mackle said. What's that? Mary asked. It happens when people are cooped up in one place for a long time. Everyone gets grumpy. Grrr! Harry growled as he stood up and dangled his arms like a monster. Song Lee giggled. I wish I could fly this coop and go to Texas, I grumbled. Miss Mackle snapped her fingers. Doug, you just gave me an idea. It's time for Room 2B to take a vacation. Yeah, we all shouted. Mary counted the days on our bird calendar. How can we? Spring break is 2 weeks away. Miss Mackle held up the globe and spun it once. The mind can take you anywhere. For homework tonight, each one of you will prepare a talk and take us to your favorite vacation spot. Tell us what it is like. Bring in family pictures, maps, or brochures if you have them. I never go anywhere, I groaned. Me either, Sydney replied. Song Lee raised her hand. She looked like she was going to cry. Yes, Miss Mackle said. I feel sick. I looked at Song Lee. She wasn't really sick. She just didn't want to stand in front of the class and give a talk. Whenever the class had a play, Song Lee had a silent part, like a dead fish or Little Miss Muffet. Miss Mackle put her hand on Song Lee's forehead. You aren't warm. Is your stomach bothering you? Song Lee nodded. I feel sick and sad all morning. Really? A moment ago you were giggling at Harry. Song Lee looked down at her desk. Miss Mackle patted her head. Don't worry, Song Lee. You can give a short little talk tomorrow. When the teacher left, Song Lee took out her pink cherry blossom handkerchief. Are you crying? I asked. Song Lee sniffed a few times. When she caught her breath, she whispered, "If I don't give talk tomorrow, I get..."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.